Hello there. So we got some recent developments with Susie Lou. Now, if you hadn't seen my video I released last week called The Susie Lou Files, I recommend you check that video out. It's linked down below in the description in case you missed it in your sub box. But in that video specifically, I go over a lot of the stuff that Susie Lou has done, continues to do, up until literally last night. The title of this video actually is not clickbait, surprisingly, because it got to the point where she finally admitted that she was, in fact, stealing raw, unedited anime episodes and presenting it as her own and charging people money for it. Not only is that a big screw you to all the people who do anime art, animate these episodes, and provide a subscription service to access them, but she released a Patreon statement as of last night, and her subscribers, her fans, are very, very upset because she's changing her business model. Hey guys, so many of you have noticed that I've taken down the backload of videos that were on this Patreon. That's because we're moving everything away from Vimeo and onto our own CDNs that we have to run for the website. So in my last video last week, I showcased a plethora of videos on her Patreon titled Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, essentially of her reacting in raw, unedited, full episodes of these animes and reacting to it in like, oh my gosh, whoa, that's so cool, I love that. Which, if you have any small understanding of fair use is for commentary, criticism, research, news reporting, and requires you to be transformative with that content, meaning that you have to provide edits and you have to edit it. You just can't upload an entire raw movie onto YouTube and make crazy facial expressions when things happen and expect people who made that movie to be okay with it. It works the same way with anime. And I know for a fact that after my video and after other people's videos before mine even went up, they were contacting Vimeo, they were contacting Tokyo TV, they were contacting these big companies that own the actual legal rights to the shows that they've created and alerting them that Susie Lou is stealing their content, but not just stealing, but charging other people to watch content that isn't hers. Overall, it's just a really scummy thing to do. She says, we've been meaning to do this for months, but we were wanting to make sure that everything was robust enough to do that there was little disruption as possible. This was actually the reason that we started the website in the first place. With the VIP on the website, we'll be able to have much more control over what we're offering in terms of the added benefits for you. Not only will you be able to get VIP exclusive videos, but we'll also be able to give you guys no ads on the rest of the site. Money off merch that we should have had by now, but the CV has put a stop to that for now. Benefits for long-term members, discounts, birthday gifts, the list is endless. All of this you can't actually do with Patreon at the moment. You don't have to worry about your Patreon pledge rolling over the next month, as we'll have a code for you to use that will give you a discount for the first month. Still working on the full details, but we'll keep you posted. Obviously, this is a big change, and the content will be different, but this means you'll be getting a lot more for your money. As for the videos moving forward, the VIP will not have to worry about the videos being transparent, but they will have edits. Now, this is a key point you need to focus on here. You won't have to worry about the videos being transparent, but they will have edits. Not only does she admit that what she was doing on YouTube right here is she was taking the video clip, changing the opacity to avoid YouTube's auto copyright bot so the episode wouldn't be flagged and thus removed, she's no longer going to be doing transparent opacities on her videos, but rather she's now, after all of this time for the last 4 to 5 months, now she's going to edit it. Let me tell you why this is happening. Because Tokyo TV, these bigger companies, finally got, this was so highly covered in the last week or two of YouTube. So many people reached out to these companies that I guarantee you, Tokyo TV, maybe even Venmo, contacted her and threatened her legally, which is within their full rights to do something like that, considering that she's taking other people's work, presenting it as her own, and making and charging money for raw, unedited videos. You can't do that. While this might disappoint some, it's to keep in line with fair use, and it keeps the companies happy too. It also means I get to continue to create reaction-based content that you guys love. More to come to the next few weeks, XX. My question to you, Susie, is why were you so resistant to people making this criticism towards you in regards to you stealing raw, unedited episodes and charging people money for them? I got these from another YouTuber by the name of Quartering. His video is linked down below. Now, instead of getting unedited videos on Patreon, we can buy merch on your site. Wow, thanks. She replies, "If that's what you took from the statement, then I feel bad for you. She can't post unedited videos, but I still don't understand why she could post them before. Did something change?" Then she replies, "No one is really allowed to post unedited. People were just getting away with it until now." So yes, you, Susie Lou, were getting away with it until now. And you made a big deal about people coming and making the criticism towards you that you were getting away with it. But now you're on top and board, you're okay with admitting that this was what you were doing all along, only after you have multi-million dollar companies threatening full legal action of you stealing and copyright infringement? It'd have been way better had you responded this way months ago. Rather, it only takes a million-dollar company for you to really admit any wrongdoing, and that's actually quite sad from a YouTube standpoint. I feel like you should be giving the same amount of importance to your Patreon followers as you do on your website. Patreon gets better content than the website, and before the website, too, that's a pretty rude comment. Would it be possible to upload 4 reactions without the video reference? We could just sync it up the video on our end, and therefore everybody's happy. Instead of making everything so darn complicated for yourself, do a timed reaction. Why create a website doing stuff in the gray zone when you could have solved it so easily? Some of the stuff people criticize you about has some truth behind it. Yes, people go far sometimes, but don't blame everyone else when you've made a mistake. She replies, "You don't even know what you're talking about, LOL. I'm not blaming anyone. This has been in the works." Another patron speaks out, "Been putting up with a lot of mistakes now, Susie, but no more. I had another account subscribe to this patron a few months ago that you banned, and all I said back then was, you could at least give us a heads up if you weren't going to post a video that day so we wouldn't waste our time expecting it. It would only take 1 minute max to do so, to make a post and say no videos today. Mind you, this was when you did daily uploads, so I had all the rights to ask, yet I got banned. Even after I gave you another chance, and also after I had heard such a lot of bad videos on your YouTube, I stayed. But no more, you have made too many bad decisions and you don't care about your true fans, the patrons. Now you took away the last thing that kept me and a lot of people here. So the full reactions, with no more full reactions equals unsubscribe. Why are you scamming people by forcing them to pay for an update you just posted on what you were doing and purging your account? You should have just refunded everybody and then closed your account. Also, purging your account is not going to completely remove proof of your copyright violation. It just is more evidence of you being guilty. And it's true, if you go to our Patreon right now, something that we covered last week on my Susie Lou Files, again, link down below in the description, recommend you check it out, give it a watch. She had at least almost like 70, almost 100 episodes of anime uploaded in its raw format, and now if you go to our Patreon, it's all gone. All gone. Each and every one, which is just, I'm kind of blown away by this, at the lack of transparency on her end, that she has no, that she kept refusing to give any merit to the people who were criticizing her, and instead just dismissed them as all haters, which is something I keep seeing so frequently. I'm so sick of people referring to my haters. It has nothing to do with hate. It has to do with you committing copyright infringement, which is already a problem here on YouTube. And then when somebody comes along with your stature, making $7,000 to $10,000 a month on Patreon, stealing content that isn't yours to begin with, yeah, people are going to have an issue with that. I have an issue with that. Now, I am curious to see how this develops and if she's actually going to make actual good edits to the content that she makes. Because if she actually edits the episodes in a way, it can and will fall under fair use if she does it properly. But again, like, you just can't edit out the end credits or the beginning credits of a particular video and then upload that raw video just editing the credits. It doesn't work that way. You have to be more transparent. Like, you have to actually make edits and have yourself injected in there with more than just simple one-word reactions or a facial expression. Fair use is actually really easy to follow along with if you take the effort, and it doesn't take a lot of effort to follow the guidelines of fair use. It really doesn't. It's easy. I do it all the time. Tons of other people do it all the time. But I'm gonna keep you guys updated on this, see where this goes, how it develops, but most of all, how she's going to get more money by doing something potentially that is against the rules of YouTube, but also against the Digital Copyright Act. So, thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day.